हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस अनदर वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन यूनिट 3. सो टिल नाउ इन द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज वी हैव सो फार सीन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कंट्रोलर्स, दैट इज पी आई, देन डी कंट्रोलर, देन पी आई डी कंट्रोलर, एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन द रेस्पॉन्सेस ऑफ दोज कंट्रोलर्स. ओके, सो नाउ इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ एक्चुअली दिस controllers are implemented in the physical form to perform the required operation they are designed for. Okay, so controller is nothing but actual controller that is going to control the, you can say, an actuator or a position of the valve. Okay, so different parameters it is going to control practically. So for that it has to have a can say practical form. So for that we are going to now see in what ways the PID controller can be implemented. So the very basic type of implementation of the controller is pneumatic controller. It has been used since very long time. So since the beginning or inception of the controller, so pneumatic controllers were in use. So basically pneumatic controller means it is used with the help of compressed air. Okay, so here air compression is used for the operations here. So it has been already mentioned that the early days PID controllers were all pneumatic type. The advantage of pneumatic controllers is its ruggedness, while its major limitation its slow response. Besides, it requires clean and constant pressure air supply. The major components of a pneumatic controller are bellows, flappers, nozzle, amplifier, air relay, and restrictors or valves. The integral and derivative actions are generated by controlling the passage of air flow through restrictors to the bellows. However, the details of the scheme of generation of PID action in pneumatic controller will be explained in different chapters. Here we are just going to see the simple implementation of a pneumatic PID controller as shown in this figure below here. Okay, so basically this pneumatic type of controller consists of four bellows, P1, P2, P3, P4. So here P1 bellow is nothing but the, you can say, pressure measuring instrument. So already we have seen this in the unit 1. So unit 2, while we were discussing about the various parameter measurement, in that we had seen about the pressure measuring instrument. So we had Bowden's tube, and then we had the bellows, which are most commonly used in different applications. So here also we see a bellow. Okay, so now here P1 is used to measure the output air pressure, then P2 is the standard set pressure value that we are expecting this output air to be with that particular pressure value. So therefore here set value is continuously being compared with the measured value, and whenever there is a difference in the measure, the two values, so that will be the error signal, and that error signal on the left hand side of this here beam, force beam, will be acting as a kind of force. So when there is a, you can say, difference, means lower value of the pressure is available, then this pressure will be applied and the pressure of the output air will be increased. So that way it will be actually act, and this is the adjustable pivot with the help of which the pressure will be adjusted on the output pressure, that is with the help of this P3. Okay, so here basically the input is air supply. That air supply is taken here, and this air supply passes through the relay. So from the relay it is going to the P3, and through the P3 it is going to output. Now while it is going to output, so through P3 it is being controlled by another valve here, restrictor. So with the help of this restrictor we can obtain the integral type of control. Okay, so here exact details are not available, but with the use of the restrictors or valves only the integration and differentiation type of control is obtained. And whatever air is flowing, so that air is air flow pressure is again fed back or measured with the help of this P3, P4, so that will be feedback below again, and the same value is also considered as the measured value. Okay, so depending upon this measured value here, so the pressure difference will be created, and depending upon that, this adjustable pivot will be adjusted in order to provide the again required or desired value of the pressure in the output air. So your explanation is here, four bellows are connected to a force beam as shown. The measured process variable is converted to air pressure and connected to the bellow P1. Similarly, the air pressure corresponding to the set point signal is applied to the bellow P2. The error corresponding to the measured value and the set point generates a force on the left hand side of the force beam. There is an adjustable pivot arrangement that sets the proportional gain of the amplifier. The right hand side of the force beam is connected to two bellows P3 and P4 and a flapper nozzle amplifier. The output air pressure is dependent on the gap between the flapper and nozzle. An air relay enhances the air handling capacity. The output pressure is directly fed back to the feedback bellows P4 and also to P3 through a restrictor valve. The opening of this restrictor decides the integral action to be applied. With a slight modification of this scheme, a pneumatic PID controller can also be implemented. Okay, but most recently this type of PID controller is not being in used, but we can say electronic type of controllers are in use. So as the, you can say, transistors were invented in mid 50s and 60s, so with the help of those transistors, amplifiers were built. So operational amplifiers are the most commonly used amplifiers, with the help of which different, you can say, operations are possible, like derivative operation can be obtained, like differential operation can be obtained, also integration can also be obtained with the help of op-amp circuits, which are called as linear integrated circuits. So now with the simple usage of those circuits, we can also build a PID controller, because PID controller essentially is a mathematical equation. Okay, so it is the, can say, model of the controller, which is nothing but the mathematical term. So here is a multiplier term or amplifier term. Simply Kp is the multiplying factor to the error signal Et. Then there is a integration term, which will be integrating the input signal. Then there is a differential term, which will be differentiating the input signal. So this can be obtained with the help of the simple electronic circuits. Okay, so here you can see a simple diagram of the electronic PID controller. So in this particular diagram, we can see that, so basically here the P controller is obtained in the beginning itself with the help of this op-amp circuit here. So all of these configurations are in terms of inverting type of amplifier. So that means the output is going to be negative here. So it is can be implemented. It can be implemented with the help of non-inverting terminal also. But for the sake of understanding the concept, it is easy to take with the inverting type of amplifiers here. This will also work in the same way. So now here the proportional amplifier will be working depending upon the values of R2 and this R1. So amplification or the gain at the output, so at this terminal whatever is coming, so that will be depending upon this error signal here. So this will be multiplied by this gain. So now here the gain is nothing but this Kp value, and this Kp value is nothing but the values R2 divided by R1. Okay, as it is going to be negative in inverting type feedback, negative feedback, so this will be like this. So we are going to get the first expression, that is Kp times E of t. Okay, so for time being we will not take the t term, so just take E. Okay, so now this is what we are going to get as Kp, the proportional part of the controller equation. Then the remaining operation is obtained with the help of the other circuits here. Okay, so again here in the first part of this circuit, you can see again there is an amplifier used, and that amplifier is again in the same way. Okay, so that will be again like it will have a kind of gain, but again this is indicated as P action, because simply you can observe here that this feedback resistor value and this resistor value are exactly same. Therefore gain of this amplifier is 1. So whatever is coming from here, that is Kp, so Kp is being multiplied by 1. So again it will remain Kp, and again the signal E as it is So all together are multiplied, and finally what we are going to get here is a simple Kp into E. So therefore this part is again the proportional part of the total PID controller. Then similarly, we know that we can design an amplifier circuit which will act as an integrator. So now here integrator is simply obtained with the help of the two elements. One is the capacitor. So if the capacitor is connected in the feedback and there is a resistor at the input, then that particular circuit will be acting as an integrator circuit. Okay, so similarly, if we need to obtain the derivative type of operation, in that case there will be capacitor again coming in play, and that capacitor will be now connected in parallel with the input resistor, or basically it is connected in the input side and the resistor will be connected in the output side. So the derivative operation is obtained with the help of the elements R5U and C2. Okay, and integral operation is obtained with the help of the elements C1, R3, and P operation is obtained with the help of R2 and R1. Okay, so these elements will be helping to obtain the final PID controller operation. And finally, whatever input is coming, so that input again here you can see this is totally from everywhere, it is RRR. So again it is gain 1 amplifier. So whatever we are getting at this point, so the same thing is available here or here, it is the same thing will be obtained here. So if three are connected together, then the final expression will be sum of this three controller actions, Kp, then Kp times that integral term, then Kd times that derivative term. Okay, so like that we will be able to get the PID operation. Okay, so now nowadays we have very easy software languages, programming languages, so therefore we can also try to implement the controller with the help of a program. So now we have also the digital PID controller. Here simply a program can replace the entire physical operation. Computer will take over the PID controller operation with the help of simple program. Okay, so now again we are going to see how we can actually obtain that programming. So program is nothing but again it is based on the algorithm. So we are going to obtain the algorithm, so like position algorithm and also the velocity algorithm can be obtained. So let us see how we can do that with the help of this mathematical expression representing the PID controller over here. So now this equation is in the time domain, so that is continuous signal, so we need to convert that into a digital signal. So digital signal is nothing but the discrete time signal which is obtained with the help of obtained with the help of sampling. So we can sample this particular continuous time signal with a uniform sampling period, so we are going to get the discrete values of the signal here. So instead of taking all the values at every instant, we are going to take the input value at the selected instance. So now this whatever discrete values are there, this set of this discrete values is nothing but the digital signal. Okay, so that set of discrete value will give us the set of discrete signal. So now converting the derivative term into discrete term, is we know that the conversion is given by, again this is completely from the signals and systems, so in depth we cannot go here. So just try to understand, the differential equation will be given by e of k minus e raised to e into k minus e of k minus 1. Okay, then there is an integral term, so we know that in case of addition, so here in the continuous time signal it is done with the help of an integral, and in case of a sequence it is done with the help of a summation. So we are going to sum all the values from 0 to t here, so 0 to t. So if you take all the instants, so then it will become I equal to 0 to k equal to whatever last instant but 1. K minus 1, so we will get all the instants. So 0th term to k minus 1 will get us all the terms between 0 to k. So those terms are summed here. Okay, so we get the integral kind of operation here. Okay, so where the sampling rate is obtained as t divided by k. Then replacing the entire earlier equation, so we get this first term is directly converted into kp into e of k, e of t is converted into simply e of k, then that integral term is replaced like this, then there is a differential term which is replaced like this. So this is p term, this is I term, and this is d term. Okay, so now whatever equation we have obtained, this equation number 2, this is called as position algorithm. Okay, so this equation, that original equation converted into the digital form is called as the positional algorithm. Okay, so this algorithm can be implemented, but there is a major problem with this kind of algorithm, that the error values at all the time instants are to be stored. So all the values between starting instant and the end instant needs to be considered in order to implement this kind of controller. So which is a very, we can say, exhaustive job, requires a lot of memories, and processing time will also increase. So instead of that, an alternative approach known as velocity algorithm is used, which can be just obtained by with the help of the earlier equation itself. So now instead of taking all the instants, so we'll select two instants, one is at instant 0 and one is at the instant say 1. Okay, so whatever is present, the signal which is present at the instant 0, so that will be represented x of k, and if the instant is present at 1, so that will be represented as x of k minus 1. Okay, so this is what the general representation of the discrete values. So now we are going to see the two magnitudes. One is first magnitude and immediately second instant magnitude. Only with the help of those two magnitudes, and what is the change in that. So only that rate of change in that particular, you can say, magnitudes of the two error values will be sufficient to obtain the required controlling action. So now let us see how we can obtain that. So first instant value is obviously given by this. Now the second instant value is given by this u of k minus 1, that is delayed by 1, or next instant value. So now here, so k is replaced by k minus 1. Okay, so we get it like this. So u of k is e of k minus 1. Here e of k minus 1 minus 1 is e of k minus 2. So now we want the difference between the two. So therefore first value minus second value. So del of u of k, subtracting equation 3. So this is equation 3 from equation 2. So del of u of k, that is the rate of change, or small change in the between the two instant, is u of k minus 1. Left hand side and right hand side is, so first term, then these all terms are simplified. So if you do the subtraction of these two equations 3 and 2, so you will be able to get the expression like this. Okay, so this expression will be obtained. So now this expression can be written in a simple form like q0 e k. So we have common terms here, one is e of k, another one is e of k minus 1, and finally we have e of k minus 2. So if you take these three terms separately, so whatever is multiplied with e of k will be replaced by q naught, whatever is multiplied with e of k minus 1 will be replaced by q1, and whatever is multiplied with e of k minus 2 is replaced by q2. So therefore if you do that simplification by multiplying the outside terms inside the bracket, then expanding that, we will be able to get the proper q1, q0 and q2 values, so which will be like this. Okay, q0 is given by kp times 1 plus tau d by tau0. Similarly q1 is minus kp times 1 plus 2 tau d by tau0 minus tau0 by tau I. Then q2 is equal to kp divided by kp times tau d divided by tau0. So this above algorithm is known as velocity algorithm. The major advantage of this algorithm is that it is of recursive type. It calculates the incremental output at each incremental output. Okay, so that del of u of k is nothing but the incremental output at each sample instant. As a result, it requires only to store three previous values, that is e of k, u of k minus 1 and finally u of k minus 2. Instead of storing all the values between 0 to infinity, we will be storing only 3 values which will be sufficient to obtain the that incremental change in the output. Based on that, we will be able to do the required controlling action. Then besides this particular requirement that it requires only 3 you can say storing elements. So this is the main advantage. Besides this, it has also got several other advantages. So first one is bumpless transfer. Bumpless transfer is a basic requirement of any PID controller. What it exactly means is, so sometimes the controller will be put in manual control and it needs to be transferred to the automatic control mode. So when it is being transferred from the manual control mode to automatic control mode, so it will see a kind of jerk. Okay, so that is called as bump. So it has to, if that bump is present in the transfer process, then it is going to lead to, we can say, unexpected change in the output. So that should be avoided. So here this velocity kind of algorithm is very efficient in doing the bumpless transfer. So that is the first advantage. Then there is another advantage, that is prevention of integration wind-up. So integration wind-up is again one of the main issues in PID controller because of the presence of the I controller. So now what happens? So when there is a set point value changes, say we have initially decided that our output required is 100, but suddenly we may make the set value as 50. Okay, so that will be the you can say 150. So we have changed set value from 100 to 150. So we have made our set value larger. So because of that, what will happen? So whatever output of the plant is measured, so that output value of the plant earlier was comparing with the 100, now it has to compare with the 150. Therefore, the difference here will be the error signal. Okay, so that error signal will be now too large. Okay, so now error signal is too large. Based on that, the controller has to produce the larger amplification value. So that will that needs to be converted into a command which will make the actuator to perform the required application performed operation to suffice that particular increase in the magnitude. But now the actuators are limited by their own operation limit. Okay, so they will have a characteristics like this. So on the negative side, they will operate at some point, and also at the positive, they are going to operate at some level. So this is called as the saturation level. Now if the error signal is larger, so because of that, the actuator is expected to work beyond this, which is not possible by the actuator. So in that case, the system will enter into oscillation because the output is never going to match as the actuator is limited. Has got limited operation. So therefore the system will enter into unwanted oscillations. So that is called as integration wind-up. Now this needs to be completely eliminated, or we have to provide some, you can say, anti-wind-up methods, so which will remove this kind of wind-up situation. Okay, so therefore there are different methods which we will not discuss in this particular video lecture. We can refer the content available in the PDF documents here, which is exhaustive in much detail to understand the concepts. Okay, therefore here you need to understand that this velocity algorithm will be very useful to overcome that kind of, you can say, bump. So if there is a sudden change in a set point, error will increase continuously to take a value summation e of k in position algorithm to a large value. Afterwards, even if the error reduces to zero or changes sign, summation e of k will take a large time to come to zero or change sign, resulting in integration wind up. But in the velocity algorithm, as soon as the error changes sign term corresponding to the integration in equation 4, that is the last equation, it will change sign. Thus, even if the actuator is saturated, it will come back to linear range within one sampling period. So here the time required is very less compared to the position algorithm. So it will take only one sampling period, which is very, very small when we consider, because it will be usually in terms of microseconds. That sampling period is in terms of microseconds. So therefore, it doesn't make much difference to that. Then also there is one added advantage, that it protects against computer failure. Another advantage of velocity algorithm is its ability to protect the process in case of computer failure. In case there is a failure of the computer, there will be no increment or decrement of the control input. and it will retain the last value before the computer failure, thus preventing process failure. Okay, so if the computer is suddenly shut off, so whatever last value was present in the computer, so that will be considered as the reference value and it will work according to that. Okay, so therefore it doesn't much affect that computer failure to affect on the operation here. So however, there are certain pitfalls of LOS algorithm also. In case of presence of noise in the measurement of the error value at particular sampling instant, the controller will immediately act, taking it to be a signal. But in position algorithm, the integration term will prevent this kind of such quick action. So sometimes a digital filter with low pass characteristics is used to filter out the unwanted noise before it reaches the controller output. So here what is happening, so we are taking the two adjacent instant magnitudes as the reference value, but due to some error, or you can say unwanted disturbance, there is some abnormal value present in the that particular signal. So it is directly going to take reference of that and suddenly it is going to act on that, but that should be avoided as it is the unwanted disturbance. So for that, here the position controller is you can say having advantage, because it will eliminate that kind of chance, as it is going to take very large sequence of the magnitudes, not just two magnitudes or three magnitudes. But velocity algorithm takes only three magnitudes, so it has more likely to get act upon the that particular unwanted disturbance signal also. So in order to avoid that, we have to make sure that there is a filter connected in the controller which will prevent such kind of disturbance signal to pass through it. Okay. So now this is the implementation of the PID controller. So here basically you need to prepare for the three types of this implementation. So most likely is the electronic and the digital algorithms, digital way of implementing the controllers most likely to come in your examination. So and also it is very simple to prepare as question answer. So try to prepare and also try to remember the various advantages of the digital implementation of the PID controller. Okay, so I hope you got some understanding from this particular unit. So you can watch it once again to understand more, and also go through the PDF content of this particular topic to understand all the concepts clearly. Okay, I hope you have enjoyed this video, and happy learning till the next time.